familiar passage of scripture. We have talked to you before from this passage, but the Lord has laid it on my heart. I want to talk to you again from the fifth chapter of the book of Romans, verse 1 through 5. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand, and we rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation works patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Look at your neighbor just before you take your seat and say, neighbor, I am not ashamed of the hope I've been given. Look at somebody else and say, neighbor, I'm not ashamed of the hope I've been given. Now give God a praise as you take your seats. The question has been asked as to what does hope mean to the believer, or what is the biblical definition of hope? Well, at least one explanation is hope is essential to us for joy. So it's critical to have, because the Bible tells us that the joy of the Lord is our strength. If it wasn't for hope, most of us, if not all of us, who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ would be of all men most miserable. And the hope that's in the Bible is much different than the hope that is in the world. The hope of the Bible is not, I hope my team wins the Super Bowl, or I hope I get a raise. Biblical hope is not a hope so. It is a no so. I know it's so, that he will keep the feet of the saints, and the wicked shall be silent in darkness. I know it's so, that he will keep me as the apple of his eye and hide me under the shadow of his wings. I know it's so, that he will not cause his anger to fall upon us, for he is merciful, and he will not keep his anger forever. I know it's so, that the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep our hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. I know it's so, that our God is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. And it's in our Bibles, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If anybody ought to know and say it so, it is the redeemed of the Lord. It was Jesus himself who told us in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. You shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Can I get a witness this morning? Understand that we are not wishing for the best. We are not waiting to see what happens and hope that it turns out well. The hope of the Bible is not a feeling or an emotion, but biblical hope is the knowledge of the facts. If someone says to you that I hope you have a good day, there is no guarantee that the day will be a good day. So that is just wishful thinking that has no power to bring anything to pass. We should understand that human hope pales in comparison to biblical hope. The believer's definition of hope is far superior to that of the world. Instead of wishing or hoping for something to happen, we know that our hope is solid, concrete evidence, because our hope is grounded in the Word of God, and we know that God cannot lie. Numbers 23 and 19 tells us that God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Has he told you something that he will not do? Or has he spoken something that he will not make good? And according to the writer of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, we have a hope that is the assurance of things hoped for and the evidence or the conviction of things not seen. And my brothers and sisters, to have a biblical hope is to have a sure anchor of the soul. It is a hope that is like faith, a faith that cannot be moved by circumstances or moved by what the eyes see, because an unseen God is seen in his faithfulness. I can see him, but daily I see his faithfulness up in my life. It was the prophet Jeremiah who said in the third chapter of the book of Lamentations, beginning with the verse 21, he says, "This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness." And my brothers and sisters, when you remember or when you recall that the omnipotent God has at all times a sympathetic consciousness of where you are and the burdens you are dealing with a desire to alleviate it, it strengthens and it sustains your hope in God. So we should understand today that hope is an extraordinary spiritual grace given to us by God to manage our doubts and our fears. Somebody once said that where there is life, there is hope. And where there is hope, there is anything you desire. And I just believe that this is the positive mindset every believer ought to have, regardless of your past experiences. It has been said before that yesterday is a history, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift from God, which is why we call it the present. All of us, regardless of status, experience some dark days in our lives, and that just comes with the territory of living life. But at the same time, we should remember that only in the darkness can we see the stars. So then even the darkness that appears up in our lives from time to time has some benefit. It was David who said, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me." David is saying, even in the face of death, where it gets no darker than that, he says, there is hope. My brothers and sisters, if you woke up this morning, congratulations. That means you're alive. And if that's not something to rejoice about, then I don't know what is. I like the words of Tom Bodett, who said a person needs just three things to be truly happy in this world: someone to love, something to do, and something to hope for. And the Bible puts it like this: now abide of faith, hope, and charity. These three, and the greatest of these is charity. Understand that the very least you can do in your life is to figure out what you hope for. And the most you can do is live inside of that hope. Don't just admire it from a distance, but live right in it. Live under the roof of hope. Hope can be a powerful force in your life. And although there is no magic in it, but when you know what you hope for most, and then a hope, and then hold it like a light within you, you can make things happen. Ministry happens for people who refuse to let go of their hope. Healings of your bodies happens for people who refuse to let go of their hope. Prosperity and good health happens for people who persevere in a hope. And losing a job or losing your house or your car is tough. But losing your hope is a disaster. And my brothers and sisters, don't spoil what you have by spending all your time, focused on what you don't have. Remember that what you have now was once among things you only hoped for. The car that you now have, the house that you now live in, the job that you have, the career, the business that you now have, all used to be things that you hoped for. So if he gave you all the things you now have, what makes you think he can't or he won't give you the things you are hoping for now, especially when you maintain and sustain that godly intense anticipation and that earnest expectation that's in you because of your relationship with God. Remember, the Bible tells us in Psalms 37, beginning with verse number 1, "Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut off like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shall ye dwell in the land, and verily you shall be fed." He says, "Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires or the hopes of your heart." Now, this is not to say that life is easy and without its challenges, but I believe it's true that most of the important things in the world have been accomplished by people who kept on trying when there seemed to be no hope at all. These people adopt the mindset that in this world, you just have to hope for the best and then prepare for the worst. And take whatever God sends or permits to come your way. That's the mindset that sustains your praise. That's the mindset that sustains your worship. That's how you can say with conviction, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Understand, my brothers and sisters, that happiness is not something that you can travel to or something you can earn, wear, or consume. But true happiness, long-term happiness, is the spiritual experience of living every minute with love, with grace, and with gratitude. Happiness is grown from the inside out. It does not come from what is external to who you are on the inside. And we should understand that our lives are shaped by the end we live for. And we are made in the image of what we desire. And that's why it's critical to know that we are more than just human beings having a spiritual experience. But the main thing is, we are spiritual beings having a human experience. And we must keep the main thing, the main thing. So then sustaining our spirituality should be primary and everything else secondary. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things that you hope for shall be added unto you. Put God first, and the car, the house, the job is added in your blessings. And when you understand this, it will change your perspective of what really matters in life, and change your aspirations, change your desires, change your expectations, and even the pipe dreams you have for your life. Hope is power. Amen. Hope gives you the ability to control your life without frustration and anxiety. Hope gives you the ability to produce the effects or the change that's needed to take you to the next level of faith up in your life. It gives you the ability to control your emotions when it seems like all hell is breaking loose up in your life. Hope gives you the power to glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation works patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And this hope, this earnest expectation, this intense anticipation will never fail or give cause for shame, because the love of God is shed abroad in your hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given to us. And everybody ought to know that greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. That's why I'm glad I have the Holy Ghost. That's why David said, you can have everything I own, but take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Is there anybody up in the house that's just glad that you have the baptism of the Holy Ghost? Then clap your hands and give God a praise up in this house. Come on and clap your hands and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise just for the Holy Ghost. And this power creates the ability to act or produce the effects needed and to reach our destiny. It's power to produce the mental and moral efficacy and efficiency as well as competency to do what you have been called to do. With this power, you have the authority, and you can command, you can control, you have dominion, you have reign, and you are master over every situation and circumstances intended by demonic forces to take you out. My brothers and sisters, I wonder how many up in here know that you have the spiritual capacity to handle the devil on every level. And that's not all, you know, but we also are aware of the fact that we have access into an environment of grace that cannot be penetrated by any diabolical force. I'm covered by the grace of God, and all I'm saying is that no weapon, Rodney, no weapon formed against me can prosper. And if it doesn't hurt me, if it doesn't wound me, that's okay, because a weeping only endures for a night, but joy will come in the morning. Somebody up in here who's going through something right now ought to clap your hands, because you are on the verge of the morning. The morning in your life is about to break through. Come on and clap your hands. Somebody up in here ought to put your foot on the devil and with authority tell the devil, you can't touch my hope, you can't touch my confidence, you cannot touch what God has given to me. And things turn out best for those because we have the power to make the best of how things turn out. Clap your hands and give God a praise. The pain of this house. And so today, I thank God for the hope that does not shame us. It's that hope that gives strength in times of weakness. It's that hope that keeps me singing though I cry. It's that hope that keeps me pressing toward the mark when the road is rough and the going is tough and the hills are hard to climb. It's that hope that keeps telling me this pain, this sorrow, these tears, this too will pass. I have this hope that late in the midnight hour, when it's the darkest, God is going to turn some things around and make it work in my favor. Check your neighbor and tell them it won't always be like this. The Lord is perfecting that concerning me. But sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor because he's turning it around for me. There's a hope will heal my body. There's a hope will deliver my soul. There's a hope will say to you, it'll pick you up when you stumble and catch you when you fall. Hope is the reason I get back up. Hope is the reason I wake up every morning with the testimony that this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. It's a hope that wipes my tears away and turns by midnight in the day. It's a hope that sustains my worship. It sustains my praise. I gotta praise and I got to get it out. Don't care what I'm going through. Don't care what I'm up against. Don't care that my back is against the wall. I still have a praise. Hope is the reason I'm still holding on.
Hope is the reason I still have a song. After all I've been through, hope is the reason I still have my joy. Grab somebody by the hand, shake it like you're gonna take it, and say, neighbor, after all I've been through, hope is the reason I still have my joy. And all I'm saying is, I still have my sanity. I still have my peace. I still have my courage. All because in the words of the songwriter who said, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I did not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness seems to hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, on Christ. Come on, talk to somebody. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. And so the apostle tells us that we are to rejoice in this hope. And today, my shout is not about manifestation, but I'm shouting on expectation. I declare and I decree that something good is about to happen up in my life. Is there anybody up in here who can shout on expectation? Clap a high five on your neighbor and say, neighbor, I haven't seen it yet, but I got a feeling in just a few minutes it's gonna manifest up in my life. Is there anybody up in the house who believes that God's getting ready to release some blessings that's been promised in your life? Then come on and give God a praise. Touch your neighbor one more time and say, neighbor, I declare, I decree that something good is about to happen up in my life. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm dancing, I'm happy, I'm celebrating my expectations. I expect the shame and the pain cannot be sustained, and that's why I give God a praise. I expect a miracle. I expect a breakthrough in my family. I expect a breakthrough in my finances, and that's why I praise him in the dance. I expect my disappointments to change to appointments. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I expect my disappointments to change to appointments. I'm appointed to be blessed. I'm appointed to be healed. I'm appointed to get exceeding abundantly above all I can ask or think. And though he slay me, yet will I trust him in all my appointed time. I will wait till my change comes. One more time, clap your hands in the face of the devil and tell the devil, I expect my miracle. It's coming. My miracle, my breakthrough, my prosperity, my change is coming. Is there anybody up in the house who will give God a praise for the blessing that's on the way? Come on, somebody up in the house and give God a praise like it's already here. Touch your neighbors and neighbors. I got a praise. I got a praise, and I got to get it out. Give God a praise. Open your mouth. Clap your hands. Lift up your voice. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Let's serve Him. Let's serve Him. Let's serve Him with gladness. Is there any glad folks up in the house? Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbors, it's a happy hour. It's a happy hour. It's a happy hour. I'm a happy. I'm a happy. I'm a happy. In Jesus. Oh Lord. Give God a praise. Up in this house. Like you mean it. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, I mean my praise. Y'all ain't talking to nobody. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, I'm not playing with my praise. It's not a pity party. I got a praise, a real praise of what God has done for me. He brought me out of the miry clay. Give God a praise for what He has done up in your life. Look at your name and say, I'm not giving up my hope. Because as long as I have hope, I got expectation. Because hope and expectation is synonymous. One more time, look at somebody and tell them, I'm not giving up this hope. Because my hope is my expectation. I expect. A change to take place up in my life. Is there anybody up in here who came to church with some expectations? Put your name, say, neighbor, I expect a change to take over up in my life. Tell them, I expect a change in my finances. I expect a change in my family. I expect this situation that I'm in to change. Do I have anybody up in the house who has high expectations? Give God a praise. Give God a praise. Give God a praise. I have it. Look at your name, tell them, I have it. I have a high expectation that something good is about to change in my experience. Then give God a shout out like you have an expectation that the devil can't stop, an expectation that demons and devils can't stop. I expect. I think Byron, If you are expecting something, at least you ought to act like you are expecting something. If you're not expecting nothing, you're not expecting anything. You won't be disappointed. But if you are expecting something good to happen, a change to take place for the better, then you ought to act like it. Slap a high five on your neighbor and say, neighbor, if you are expecting something good to happen in your life, then you ought to act like you expect. Go ahead and praise him. Let's take about 30 seconds. For those who have expectation, for those who have hope, spiritual hope, let's give them 30 seconds to get their praise on. Put a praise. Put a praise on your hope. Uh-huh. Come on then. About 15 more seconds. That's all right. Go ahead. Put a praise on your expectation. That's all right. Go ahead. Put a praise on it. On it. Woo! Just help me preach a little bit and look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you can always tell who's expecting their miracle because they will put a praise. On it. Go ahead. It's on the way. 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 Woo! It's on the way. It's on the way. Woo! A miracle if you want to. Woo! Woo! I feel it. It's a breakthrough about to happen. Somebody is breaking through. Breakthrough time.
Breakthrough time.
Look at God. Go ahead and give him praise then. Go ahead. Uh-huh. It's breakthrough time. Breakthrough time. Woo! Still got my hope. I'm not talking about what I wish for. I'm talking about spiritual hope, biblical hope. It's got to happen. Let me right here. In the red dress, they told her after her spine injury, they told her she wouldn't walk, that she would be in a wheelchair. But look at her now. She ain't just walking, she dancing. Daughter, go ahead. Make the devil out of a liar. Told you you weren't gonna walk. You dancing all over the church.